Hello to everyone. In this video, I'm going to discuss about the linear convolution using MATLAB software. There are two ways to have output of linear convolution in MATLAB. First one is using a standard function and second one is using the for loop according to the formula. So now we are going to write some commands. Let's get started. CLC, which is used to clear the command window. Clear all, then close all. Now I will ask user to enter the first segment xn enter the sequence one to be convolved linearly, and I will ask same again to enter the sequence two and I will name it as hn. I will find the length of both the signals using the length function. Length one for xn, we can find it using the length function length xn. So it will give the length of the xn sequence. Similarly, we will find the length for hn. Copy ctrl plus v. This will be the length of second sequence. L2. We know that in linear convolution, the output has a n plus m minus 1 sample, so we will write that formula m equal to l1 plus l2 minus 1. This number of samples will be in the output signal. Let's represent the our linearly convolved output using the third variable z. Okay, so z equal to zeros 1 comma m. So we have initialized the z with a 1 cross m matrix which with all the values as 0, so it is a 1 row and m column matrix. Okay, so now I am going to use the standard function con to find out the linear convolution of these two xn and hn. Con xn comma hn, and we will store the output in third variable that we have declared, that z. Now I'm going to display the output using the disk function z. Okay, now this one is z. Okay, now I'm going to run this program. Add to path, come on, sequence 1 1 2 3, sequence 2 1 2 3 again. So we will get the output having the five values, which is n plus m l1 plus l2 minus 1, that is 6, 3 plus 3 6 minus 1 5 sample in the output. Okay, so this is the linear convolution using the standard con function. Now we are going to find the linear convolution without using this standard convolution function. Okay, so for that, what we have to do, we have to zero pad the input signals, because in the output we will have a 7, we will have a 5 values. So let's zero pad the signal 1 xn 1 1, this will be a zero padded value of this xn comma zeros for zero array and zero padding, zeros 1 comma. Now we are going to zero pad it till 1 comma l2. Okay, 1 comma l2, right? Xn 1 comma l2 minus 1. So this will be the zero padded value of first one. We will display it now, xn 1 1, to see whether we got the right output or not. Come on, let's run it. 1 2 3 1 2 3. So we should get a 5 value. Here you can see the first signal 1 2 3 has been zero padded by 2 0 at the end of the signal, so it means zero padding is working. Similarly, we will zero pad the signal hn. Copy ctrl plus v. Now we will zero pad the another signal hn. It will be l1, because we are going to add the 3 value at the last, which will be the value which are not in the L2. So now I'm going to write a one for loop. We'll use a nested for loop following the convolution. We are having a one formula. You can remember convolution formula is xn cross convol h n minus n. So we are going to use that formula here for I equal to 1 to what is the length m. Now we will use nested loop for j equal to 1 to I. Here you can see that the indexing of the in MATLAB start from 1 instead of 0, so you have to keep this point into your mind while doing the programming in MATLAB. So now I'm going to write the funds for this. So simply we have to use another variable where we can store the output of this convolution. So now create a one more out for holding the output z1 equal to zeros 1 comma m. So we have created one more variable to hold the output. So now here we go z1 I. So z1 i equal z1 I plus x n 1 1 j cross h. Where is the h? So here should, it should be h n 1 1 in bracket. We have a formula x n into h n minus n, but here it will be n minus n plus 1 because indexing start from 1. So it will be I minus j plus 1. So this is the end. For ending the for loop, we have to add the end at the end. Second, for second, we again have to write the end. Okay, so the z will store the convolution of these two xn11 and h1n1. Now I'm going to display the value disp z1. So I hope it I will get the similar answer from this as well. Into the sequence 1, 1, 2, 3. Sequence 2 again 1, 2, 3. Enter. We can see the convolution using the con function is 1, 4, 10, 12, and 9. And 9, and convolution using the for loop is also 1, 4, 10, 12, and 9. So we have proved the convolution property. Thank you for watching. And if you want to learn more, please subscribe. Thank you very much.